It's called You're Invited to the Family Reunion. To get your copy of today's or any message on audio or videotape, simply write or call. Written correspondences should be sent to the Tape Ministry, First United Methodist Church, 1115 South Boulder Avenue, Tulsa, Oklahoma, 74119. Or call the tape office at area code 918-587-9481. Audio tapes are $3, videos are $15. If you're looking for a church home in the Tulsa area, we extend this invitation to attend one of our 5 weekly worship services. Sunday mornings at 8:30, 9:30, and 10:55. Sunday evening at 6 and Thursday evening at 6. Until next we worship together, may God richly bless you, and we hope to see you here next week.
Welcome to Union Tuttle Stadium on the campus of Union High School as TCI Cablevision of Tulsa presents the best in prep football, a game that has been anticipated to bring about 12,000, standing room only. However, the weather will keep a few away, but still, it should be a great football game, and the stands are almost full as the top-ranked and defending state champion Jenks Trojans, the top offense in the state, meet the fourth-ranked Union Redskins, who have won 4 in a row, the district lead up for grabs. Hello again, Don King along with J.B. Haney as we give you the action between 2 high-powered offenses tonight.
Don, when we talk about high-powered offenses, you're absolutely right when you take a look at what these two teams are averaging. Jenks averaging 47 points per game, Union averaging 39.8. And whether or not they'll be able to sustain that type of offense against one another, only time will tell. I don't think they can, but yet, when you look at the offensive thrust that both sides have, it could happen.
There you see capacity 10,000. They were expecting about at least 10, maybe 12. And, of course, the weather has been certainly inclement throughout the day. We've had thunder showers throughout this day, but umbrellas are up, a few of them, sprinkling at the moment as you see the crowd. We are about ready to go. Even though the weather hasn't cooperated, it certainly hasn't dampened the spirits between these two great programs. And when we come back, we'll have the opening kickoff as we get set for top-ranked Jenks and fourth-ranked Union.
It's coming, 500 channels. Somebody's got to fill them. The Rogers State College Broadcasting Division can put you in the picture. Hands-on TV production techniques taught by industry professionals. Rogers State College is the only college in the state to have a licensed TV station. Get experience, get contacts, get placement. The RSC Broadcasting Division is the right call. Rogers State College, lifetime learning, close to home.
I've always dreamed of a big family room.
Wow!
Call today, Communication Credit Union at 258-7646, the credit union for all of Broken Arrow.
I've always dreamed of a convertible sports car.
Call today, Communication Credit Union at 258-7646, the credit union for all of Broken Arrow.
Redskins have won the toss, and they'll put their high-powered offense
on the field first, featuring what might be, JB, the state's best quarterback we've seen in a long time, Justin Fuente.
Don, you're absolutely right. We've said this several times, but when Lee Snyder, a longtime Hall of Fame football coach in this area, says he's one of the best that he has ever seen in the state of Oklahoma, I think you have to agree with it. But anytime you talk about Justin Fuente, you have to keep in mind that Eric Bernard, along with Ritter, Ivory, and Claibon, really give him some great backup in there. And on the other side of the football, we'll keep a look on Presley as well, the fine quarterback for Jenks.
Well, the crowd is on its feet. This game has been probably the most publicized, the most anticipated prep game in 25 years here in the metro area. And John Wingerter, the Jenks kicker, will kick off to either Eric Bernard, number 22, or Chad Daney, number 47. And this is the star running back, Bernard, who had a kickoff return call back last week. Past the 30, up to the 32-yard line. And on the tackle after the 30-yard return, give credit to the Trojans, number 27, Scott Betichek.
This is something that both coaches feel very strongly about, Don, that their special teams have to really work and work well, and that's a good return, good field position.
Bernard, conference's leading rusher, along with Richie Kalmus of Jenks. Fuente, three wide receivers, checking off at the line. From the 32. Goes deep on first down for Steele, just off his fingertips at midfield. Interesting point about this Union team. They'll throw on first down. They did it a lot last week against, at that time, what was the state's best defense.
Don, they really will. And Justin Fuente, and of course, with the confidence that the coaching staff, Bill Blankenship, has in him, he's not afraid. And the no-huddle offense, they're not messing around.
District lead up for grabs, and here's something unusual. Caught in the backfield, or close to it, Bernard. The number 99, the nose guard, 6 foot, 188-pound senior, Richard Peaster. Pickup of a yard, actually. Third nine, and Fuente drops back in the shotgun. Mike Cottrell, the center. Snaps it back for a first down. Steele couldn't quite get there. On the defensive coverage, number one, Chris Tyler, the 5'9", 168-pound senior defensive back, and the far side are on their feet. We're underway.
Nice defensive play in there by Chris Tyler. As you mentioned, Donnie, really was putting some pressure on the pass receiver, and a great rush in there by Wisney, the All-American high school tackle, that he's going to be putting a lot of pressure on Fuente.
Dustin Steele is back to punt for the Redskins. Ananias Carson is the deep man. This one gives Jenks great field position near the 40-yard line. 27-yard punt. Not normal for Dustin Steele, who comes into the game averaging 33 yards a kick. So the Trojans and their fine quarterback, Brian Presley, a junior, will bring the Trojan offense that's best in the state at 47 points a game. Minute 15 gone, no score. First possession for the Trojans. Fullback is 41, Brian Burkhart. Tight end on the left, Ryan Dykus. He's a good one. So is this guy, Richie Kalmus. Up to the 34, 4-4 as you take a look at the Jenks offense. Richie Kalmus leading the conference and leading the area in touchdowns with 20. Dykus, a good tight end. An offensive line. The only return offensive lineman from the state championship team a year ago is Ken Hill. But those guys have done a good job. As the Trojans live on the ground most of the time.
And they don't have to give Richie Kalmus much room.
Kalmus in motion. No running back. Two tight ends. Presley goes for Kalmus. There he is. Daney to catch him and out of bounds at the 5-yard line.
41-yard pass play, well designed. Kalmus was open, and you don't hear much about Presley, but he can throw the football as well.
That was just about as nice a pass as you could find, and a great run in there, of course, by Richie Kalmus. And you'll see him sprinting out of the top of your screen, and he just flies right down the sideline. A little miscommunication, I'm sure, in the backfield right there, but Daney catching up with him, and if, without that speed, he would have scored.
They mark it at the 3 after a 53-yard pass play to Richie Kalmus. Both of these running backs are excellent pass receivers. Here's Kalmus for his 21st touchdown of the year. And quickly the Trojans jump on top. Presley will hold, and Wingerter, who has been successful on 27 PATs, will try another. And it is good. 9:49 to go opening period. Doesn't take the Trojans long. They go 60 yards in three plays, and they put the first points of the game on the board.
We'll get another look at this, Don. You see Presley down under coming out with the ball, and it's just good off-tackle run in there by Rich Kalmus. He certainly has got the power, and you noticed him on the first play of the game when he came through the line, a couple of arm tackles, and you just won't arm tackle. You're going to have to hit him straight up because for his weight, he's a 175-pounder, and he carries every bit of it.
Well, you look at those Jenks running backs in years past. They've all been built the same. They've all been the same stature, Bill Perkins, Chris Jones, all-staters, and Kalmus falls right in line.
And, you know, I'm not surprised at what Ron Lancaster's doing here by throwing that pass to Kalmus there on the second play of the game because he really was able to break him down the far side wide open.
Unusual for the Redskins to be behind, especially this early. Daney in the end zone, and that's an automatic touchback. That's a rule that needs to be changed.
You don't like that, Don.
I never have I?
No. No, you haven't.
The field appears to be in pretty good shape, JB. What do you think?
It really is, Don. I was down there before the game, and sure, it's moist, but certainly not sloppy by any means. And I don't think we'll have any effect whatsoever on the outcome of the ball game.
Again, three wide receivers for this Union offense. Off tackle, Bernard. Turns the corner. They're getting bounced off a tackle. Picks up 5. Looked like it was Wisney, 71, that he bounced off of. Take a look at this play. Look at 71 here, Wisney. He's an All-American candidate. Yeah, he gets blocked pretty well.
I think it's Jake Raymer that comes up there, and he just bounces right off right. But I'll tell you for sure that Eric Bernard is a difficult runner to get back.
Pass to Ivory. There you see the water splash up. Pick up a 13. That'll be a first down.
The synthetic surface here of the new turf in Union Stadium has a sand base, and there will be water, but it's, and you will see it flash periodically, but it's still not sloppy by any means. The traction is good.
Look at Dane Ivory, maybe the most athletic of the three wideouts. Then you got Ritter averaging 20 yards a catch, and then you got Dustin Steele, who's so dangerous after he catches it. First down of the game for Union at their own 38. Bernard runs right by Wisby, runs over a couple of Trojan defenders, picks up 8 yards, and it'll be second and short for the Redskins.
I can assure you that Eric Bernard, for his 172 pounds, he's a lot like Rich Kalmus. He carries it well, and he carries it strong.
Looking at the rushing totals, we'll have an encroachment here against the Trojans, and that'll give Union another first down. Looking at the conference rushing totals, Kalmus and Bernard are neck and neck. Bernard has 893 yards in just half the season. And
Calmus is right behind him at 862 yards, just 30 yards behind him coming into this game. And then you look at Fuentes passing, over 1,100 yards passing in just half a season. Some heady numbers by these two teams on offense. And here's Wong. To the 20-yard line. Get on the track shoes, coach.
I'll tell you, they may match their season average, Don, but here you get a good look at the quickness of Eric Bedard. Great blocking up front on the right-hand side of the line, and once he hits that secondary, he is almost gone. Just a great effort in there to save the touchdown by Terry McGowan.
When I talked to Ron Lancaster this week, he wasn't so much worried about Puente as he was this guy, 22.
Well, that's what's made Union such a tremendous offense, is the fact that they've got the great running back in there with Eric Bedard. And not only that, but his substitute, Chris Claiborne, can come right in and continue the same momentum as far as the ground game is concerned.
And I'm not trying to take anything whatsoever away from Puente, because Ron Lancaster certainly respects this gentleman's abilities. But he says, first, to beat Union, you got to stop Bedard. Second seven from the 17, play action. He has time. Quillum, the tight end. Great block. Ivory closed it out for him at the goal line. Settle in, because this one has the makings of something rather classic. Ritter, yes.
Here we get a good look at the finesse that you can see, a great fake in there as Fuente rolls out to his right, and once he does, there's not much doubt that he's going to complete that down there to his tight end, Chad Quillum. Hurdles him. Great block in there by Dane Ivory that kind of sprang him loose.
Quillum's second touchdown of the year, his eighth catch of the year. So it didn't take the Redskins long, did it? They didn't even have a third down on that six-play drive.
No, and Don, just looking around the stadium, it has filled now, and I'm sure that there's going to be the good, strong 10,000. Everyone projected on the north end. They're standing along and outside the end zone. So high school football at its best right here at Union Stadium.
Interesting, you were talking to Lee Snyder, who coached that Nathan Hale team in 1969. Of course, that story's been written in the paper in the 69 state semifinal game. That was at Skelly Stadium, over 30,000. That was televised between Hale and Washington. But you thought that the high school crowds have been up this year.
I think they have, Don, especially in the outer area, even within the Tulsa Public Schools. I think they're up, which it's just good for high school football.
Calmus on the reverse to Carson at the 20. This is Tyler Ritter. Nope, this is Carson. I beg your pardon. And Anias Carson, number 3, who has 4 touchdowns on the year. The return up past the 30 to about the 33. And that'll be good for 20 yards on the return. On that drive, Puente was 3 of 4 passing.
And one thing for sure, you're going to see all stops come out in this game here. As you see the reverse coming here, it's a great, great reverse there. Of course, once you get the ball in there to Carson, only 5'8", 145, he is a scant back.
Burkhart to fullback in motion. Fumble. Presley falls on it.
Both coaches, Don, felt that in a game like this, that mistakes will ultimately determine who wins. And if you fumble a ball and can come up with it, well, you just saved yourself an error and dodged the bullet.
Jenks has won the last two meetings between these two schools and overall have the lead 12-6. But you look back to the last 6 games between these two teams, and a touchdown has separated the outcome in all 6.
a story on the Trojan record against their opponents, or their opponents' records, as Carson carries up to the 40-yard line, gets 7 on the tackle, Chad Daney, but not before Carson puts the Trojans in good shape with a 3rd and short situation.
Ronnie Lancaster really gets a lot of movement in his backfield, but they will constantly be going lateral, and this time we see the reverse coming back kind of on a crossbuck with Carson, and picks up a few yards, but a well-executed play.
3rd down and short, 3rd and 3. Presley changing the play. Double tight end situation on 3rd and short. Kalmus averaging 7 yards a carry. Bounces off one man. 1st down to the 45 and slides up to the 47 and picks up 6. Nice run by Richie Kalmus, 6 foot, 175 pound senior, as Ron Lancaster looks on in his 4th year at Jenks, a record of 32-6.
Richie Kalmus really showed you the strength that he has that time when Steve Hobbs, he's a 205-pound linebacker, just bounced off of him. He had him in the backfield but couldn't wrap him up, and that's just a lot of strength for Richie Kalmus.
3 wideouts now for Jenks. Looking like the Redskins a bit. Blitz is on, they pick up Steele. Presley, oh! Josh Dupler, the 5'7", 140-pound senior defensive back. 1 year Letterman came up with a huge play that time.
I mean, that was a big play, and it looked like he was beaten there, but Dupler's able just to get up, and there's some great poise back there by Presley as well. Step back up into the pocket, and there you see the deflection by Dupler right at the last moment to prevent a sure touchdown for the Trojans.
Kalmus slips down at the line of scrimmage. In fact, loses a couple. 52 leading the way for Union with Steve Davis, the senior defensive tackle, who's a transfer from McAllister. Midway through this 1st period, tied at 7. Jenks got the ball first, scored 3 plays. Union got it right back and went 80 yards in 6 plays. Jenks has their 2nd possession here of the game. Presley on 3rd and long. Diving catch, yes, it's a 1st down. Jeff Beasley off the bench, and the senior wideout makes a 1st down diving catch to the Union 32. Pick up a 24.
And that's just a tremendous catch in there by Jeff Beasley that time. He's outstretched just about as far as he can. You can't beat a play like that.
Down to the skin, 32-yard line. Presley hasn't thrown an interception this year. In fact, neither quarterback very rarely throws the pick. Chris Tyler into the game. He gets double teamed, but not before he gets from the 32 to 28 for 4. Tyler's an interesting story. He's been out most of the season with an injured thumb.
Just a nice little pitch there by Presley. And Don, we haven't said enough about his passing. He certainly has just been very, very convincing on his throwing in the early going.
Tyler has just been back into action since last week. He just took the screws out of his left thumb this week. Here he comes right side. He's got great speed. And a saving tackle by Daney. He probably prevented a Jenks touchdown that time.
Chris Tyler is certainly showing some quickness and some speed as he comes back across the grain and just scoots out the outside, gets a pretty good block in there, and just a shirt-saving tackle in there, Don, by Daney, or absolutely, it was a sheer 6 points.
Tyler is a senior but didn't play much last year until the very end of the season, and Presley likewise, and yet they both helped Jenks win the state championship. Misdirection to Tyler. Dustin Steele with a big play, and the Rover
tackles Tyler for a loss of three, back to the 20. They call him MacGyver.
Well, Dustin Steele then certainly executing the basic fundamental of tackling in football. Once he comes up and just zeroes in on him, you'll see him as he moves down the line. He gets his head right in front, prevents him from getting on through. No arm tackling there, putting the shoulder on.
And that's why, all-purpose player indeed. Jenks needs to burn a timeout with 3:11 remaining, first period. Again, the most anticipated prep game in probably 25 years. Number one Jenks against number four Union on TCI, and it's being brought to you by State Bank. By RSC-TV, Rogers State College Television. By Eastern Oklahoma Orthopedic Center and Sports Medicine Center. And by the Williams Companies. Seven our score. Last year Jenks won this game 31-24. Year before that here on this turf, or at least at this stadium, we have a new turf this year. But the Trojans won 14-11. There's Myron Noodleman getting the Union crowd as if they weren't already at a fever pitch. The Trojans have won four of the last five, including the last two. Tied 7-7. They're threatening again. Presley's 2 out of 3 passing, and that pass off the shoulder pad of Tyler.
Tyler would like to try that one again, Don. It was thrown just a little bit behind him and caught him on the shoulder pad right there, but I think he was out and free that time as well. He's being pursued there by Matt Wilson, but don't believe he could have caught him.
Presley, again, no interceptions this season, and only 4 in 128 passes coming into this game in his career. Now 4 in 132 passes. And probably delay a game, but we'll see. Trojans always do a lot of shifting at the line of scrimmage, don't they?
They really do, and they have that lateral movement going down the line of scrimmage, and, you know, the touchdown that Kalmus set up with that long run early in the first period while he was moving and left the entire backfield vacant. There was no backs in there, and that's where the defense got confused when he turned upfield.
Trojans are averaging 47 points per game. Best in the state. And boy, wasn't there a time a few years ago when the Trojan fans were up in arms because their offense could never score enough points to win big games. Not any longer. Answered that last year in the state championship game, coming from behind to beat Edmond. Presley on 3rd and 13. Pump fake. Chased out of the pocket. Needs to run it. Gets buried at the 20-yard line. Picks up 5 to make it 4th and 13, and we'll see if Wingerder comes on for the field goal.
Watching him kick before the game, Don, he's got a tremendously strong leg. He was putting them in from the 30, 35, and once I saw him kick one from the 40, so he's got the strength to get it through there. We'll see whether or not Ron Lancaster, he's going to elect to go for it.
Steve Davis, 5'7", 225-pound senior, gives chase and then gets help from 3 other red shirts. Wingater will try the field goal off the hold of Presley. This will be from 37 yards out. He has a field goal this year. This one's got the distance. Good. Wow.
Well, you have to wonder, Don, can this pace be maintained for 4 quarters? Because it appears that every time they get the football, either team, that they're going to be marching it down within scoring distance. Either go for the 6 or get a 3-point field goal.
Last three possessions have produced points. This one for 37 yards out. Wingerter's longest field goal of his career, his only other field goal of the season, was good from 32 yards out. Nathan Ritter, on the other hand, has kicked 3 years for Union and has 7 career field goals. And it could very well come down to the kicking game between these two schools. .254 remaining opening period. That was almost a 5-minute drive. Taken at the 7-yard line by Bernard. So dangerous. Great blocking. .82, Wingerter, the kicker, drops him shy of the 40-yard line.
Eric Bernard can pick out the holes, play off his blockers, Don, about as good as any high school running back you'll see. As he brings the ball up, he just really has that unique ability right there just to cut in the seam, pick up that extra 7 or 8 or 9 yards.
I don't think I've seen a team consistently do it. I mean, every once in a while, a high school team will break one, but they do it for over 30 yards every time. Play action. Quinte, wide open to Quillen, the tight end. He gets one block from Ritter and gets close to the first down marker up near the 50-yard line.
And, Don, I think that shows you the respect the Trojans have for Eric Bernard that time. A great fake in there by Fuente that just took the defense to the near side here, stacked up on Bernard and leaving it wide open on the far side.
Up to the 47 for 9 yards. Jenks showing 8 in the box here, 8 up front. Fuente drops back on second and short. Steal, can't get his hands on it. He hasn't caught one yet. Ivory has a catch. Quillam has 2.
You watch these two football teams play and you really think that on every play you're going to see a touchdown. Every play is going to be, if it's a running play, they're going to break it. And you know the defense is not that bad because Jenks ranks third in the state in defense as well.
Bernard set deep. Inside Jenks territory. Thing that gets me about Bernard, maybe more than anything, reminds you a little of Barry Sanders, because in that formation, they spread you out so thin. He has no lead block. He has no fullback. So he pretty much gets to the line and then picks his own hole.
And he has that great acceleration. It looks like that he's just kind of playing along, and then suddenly he hits that afterburner and he's going just as soon as he can see daylight in an opening.
To the Jenks 48. Minute 40 remaining opening period. Trojans lead 10-0. Union's never had the lead. They pressure him here, and it's almost intercepted. Jake Raymer, number 21, had a dive at it. That's the first pressure on Fuente in the game.
And yet he hung right in there and released the ball, made a pretty good throw on it, a throw that was catchable. And I think that's a great thing about Justin Fuente. Almost every pass he makes is a catchable pass. Some of them, you may have to have a little more ability to catch it than others, but he puts it in there pretty close every time.
3-year starter for the Redskins, who's thrown for over 4,000 yards, over 4,400 yards. Bernard drops one on second down. Don't see that often.
No,
I think he was so eager to take off.
And that's a fundamental that you will see not executed on any level of football, baseball, or basketball. Don is not looking the ball in, but running before you get the ball, turning and going upfield. And he knew he was so wide open that he could get some yardage and just got a little eager.
Third and 10 from the Jenks 48. Minute and a half remaining. First period from a sold-out Union Tuttle Stadium. Jerry Wisney on the loose. But it might have been intentional grounding. No call. It'll be fourth down. And you saw one kid, Fuente, who's being recruited by Stanford, Texas, Tennessee, and UCLA, being pressured by another kid, being recruited by Notre Dame, Michigan, Stanford, Penn State. A couple of all-staters indeed right there.
Here's Steele for his second punt of the night. Again, not a very good kick. Very short kick from the 48 down to about the 45, 43, we'll see. It'll be about a 5-yard punt. Wow. And the Trojans have great field position again. And there's Bill Blankenship in his third year. So don't worry about it. You can read his lips.
You know, they're bringing in a fresh football on every down and wiping it off. But maybe there's more moisture down there than we think, Don. And it could be the ball is getting a little heavy.
Great field position again for the Trojans, who already lead 10-7. And have the ball. Great field position at the 43. And Presley opens it up again. I think he was out of bounds. No, they say he was in bounds when he caught it. It's good for 5 up to the 48-yard line.
Really looked like that time that, who was it, Ben Owens was doing a lot of dancing, just trying to keep one foot in bounds, which he was able to do, and picked up about 5 or 6 yards on it.
Presley, tough throw right there.
Yeah, you can see he stayed in there. Yes, the official was right on it over there. He could see it.
Owens is their backup tight end, 6'1", 180 junior. Gain of 5, that many yards needed for the movement of the sticks. Kalmas for about 3, 4.
Big third down coming up for Union.
Now, Union's defense really needs to stop them here at the Union 49, where they face a 3rd and 2. This is a Union defense that hasn't gotten much respect, but Steve Spavital, certainly a well-known defensive coordinator for the Redskins, has no big names like you do on the offense with Fuente, Bernard, Steele, although Steele does play on defense. Ooh, popped there, but Kalmas shows his strength again, JV, and spins for the first down.
It's just almost impossible to bring Richie Kalmas down on one blow, because you could see a pretty good lick was delivered in there by John Bradbury, but he just couldn't bring him down.
Ouch. Steve Hobbs, the linebacker, really got tattooed. The Trojans have won 10 in a row since they lost at Owosso last year here on TCI Cablevision. They're more of a finesse team this year than they are a power team. Presley dodges the sack over the head of Jake Crisop, who's in at fullback. 9 seconds left on the first period clock.
Well, you have to be impressed with Brian Presley. Had a lot of pressure put on him that time. Got him out of the pocket, and he was looked like he was falling backwards, but was still able to get the ball off and didn't get it completed, but he got it in the area.
So after the incompletion, they'll start again. Draw play, 46-yard line. Kalmas to the 40. Kalmas close to the first down marker, out of bounds with 2 seconds left. And the Union fans, or rather the Jenks fans, are wanting unnecessary roughness after the run of 8 yards by the senior running back.
Looked like the flag was thrown after a second Union player went in there. I think the initial contact that was made in there, I believe it was Brian Moon, looked like.
Indeed, it will give the Trojans a first down. We take a look. 1, 2, 3 guys at him. 4 guys. Finally, nope. Jeremy Pike, yep, brings him out, and then Daney, 47.
That's where the flag comes from, the second man going in. I said Brian Moon, it was Jeremy Pike that took him out.
1 second left on the opening period clock. So this will be our last play in what has been quite a bit of action up to now. Certainly don't see why it won't continue. From the Union 22, Presley going upstairs again. Gets pressured. Look out. To the 13-yard line, and that's where we will return
at the Union 13-yard line on a second and short when we continue between the top-ranked Jenks Trojans, defending state champions, and the fourth-ranked Redskins. After one period, it's 10-7 Jenks on TCI Cablevision of Tulsa.
Only a good energy food for the active athlete? No, it's also the best initial treatment for sprained joints. Are we advocating putting Rice on a sprained ankle? Not exactly. You see, Rice is a memory word for rest, ice, compression, and elevation, the best beginning treatment for injured joints. Apply compression carefully. Remember, a wrinkled or too tight ACE wrap can act like a tourniquet. Then elevate and rest the extremity and pack it in ice. When in doubt, with any extremity injury, remember, ice is nice.
Second one from the Union 13-yard line. Pitch to Kalmus. Gets the first down and inside the 10. Gets about three. That's another first down, and the Trojans pick up their seventh first down of the game. Union has four. Now, I just heard the Jenks Trojan coaches in the next booth say, look out for the fullback trap. So we'll watch the fullback. Ryan Burkhardt is the fullback, number, or rather it is Chrisop, number 40 now in at fullback, 5'11", 190 junior. Also the starting weak side linebacker. First and goal from the 10. Kalmus gets a yard, that's it, and gives Steve Hobbs all the credit in the world, along with 16, Dustin Steele. Hobbs is 46. They combine to make the stop. Hobbs, one of the co-captains. Kind of reminds you a little bit of another great linebacker here, Jeff Leiding, and they are certainly... Both schools have had great linebackers in the past.
They really have, Don, and they've had some great individual talent on both sides of the football at both schools back from the time when they were really Class B and through their growth up to Class 6A.
Jenks needs to burn another timeout. This is the second timeout that they've used in this half.
Well, you know that Ron Lancaster and his staff would like to get in for six on this possession. They don't want to get down this close. They got good field position on the chain punt and was able to get it down to where they are right now, and they certainly would like to score and not just come away with 3 points.
Lancaster, who played his prep ball at Tulsa Webster, was an assistant for quite a few years in the Tulsa Public Schools area, then went to California where he was a head coach, took teams out there to prominence, state championship, came to Enid in the early 80s and took Enid to a state championship when they had Liddell Carr. Now in his fourth year at Jenks, and Bill Blankenship growing up in Spiro.
Bill Blankenship's from a football family, Don. His father was a great coach at Spiro for many, many years, Hall of Famer, and Bill has followed his footsteps and played football with David Raiders, University of Tulsa. But the no huddle offense right here, sometimes it looks like a junior Hurricane ball club.
The way T.E.'s been scoring points. Could be the senior. Second go from the 10, but it does look an awful lot. You're right, like T.U., the offense they run. Here we go. Second goal from the 10. Kalmus. Wow, what effort. What effort by this kid, Rick T. Kalmus. 6 foot. 175-pound senior who last week had 209 yards and 6 touchdowns against Memorial.
And credit Derek Collins, and they're really coming off the line of scrimmage defensively for the Redskins, and he's the one that makes the first contact, but even there, he still spins out and is going to have some
help. Here's a Union defense, big play here, third go from the 12. That shut Jenks down last time for 3 points. Here they'd like to do it again. Play action pass. He has a man wide open at the 5-yard line, out of bounds at the 3. And now we'll see if they go for 6 or do you go for the field goal? Ben Owens with his second big reception on this drive.
You know, this is not an easy decision to make for Coach Ron Lancaster and his staff because of the explosives of Puente. And even though you haven't pinned down, it's still not going to have their back to the wall. Great pass in there by Presley, taking his time rolling out, picking out his receiver in there, Ben Owens, almost in.
Ivory saved the touchdown, and they'll go for it. Wide out to each side. Carson on the left. Presley pitches. Calmus wrapped up once, but not enough. Touchdown, Jenks, but a flag is down. A flag is down on the play. It looked like the defensive left tackle, that would be 70 Collins, had him wrapped up. As you can tell in the background, the flag is against Jenks. It'll be holding. And that's the first big break for the Redskins tonight.
That is a big break for Union, and Chad Daney that time coming in from his free safety position. Looked like he had Calmus just wrapped up, but Calmus is such a strong runner, got those real strong legs. Here you see Chad Daney coming in, wrapped him up, but just couldn't get him, and he takes another pretty good blow right there at the goal line, but is able to go ahead and break that one and get in.
All right, here's another field goal attempt by Wingerter. W-I-N-G-E-R-T-E-R. Got the distance from 31 yards out, and you can put it on the board.
Well, you certainly like to come away with points on the board every time you get down inside the 15, 20-yard line, Don, but that has to be a boost for the defense for Union High School that they've been able to hold this real strong Jenks team out twice and make them go for field goals.
And we got to the Union 20, and had to settle for, actually got to the Union 17 and had to settle for a field goal. Then they get down to the Union 3, and even though they had a touchdown called back, a holding penalty, they have to come back with three more, and they lead it 13-7. It could have very well been 17-7. 10:07 remaining first half. And the last three times, in fact, the only three times that the Trojans have had the ball, they've scored. Union scored the second time they had the ball. Short punt also set up that last play. Look out, loose ball, Jenks has it. Recovery, sophomore Corey Callens, who wears a very familiar number from a year ago, their kicker from a year ago, Adam Smith, great player on that state championship team, and watched Daney fumble the kickoff on the wet turf, wet football.
You know, after he fumbled it, he then kicked it before Jenks came up with it, and now that's a great break for the Trojans in there, but a break that they make, and one thing for sure, they weren't going to kick that ball if possible around Eric Bernard.
Well, they really put their defense in a hole here at the 20-yard line. After Union got a big break, Jenks comes up with a momentum builder. And the lateral to Calmus. He loses the ball at the 22. That was a lateral all the way to Calmus. And a loss of two. One or two. Lancaster shaking his head.
Steve Hobbs will come up after the completion right here. You'll see number 46 just slapping at the ball, knocked the ball out, and Calmus was able to recover it.
Hobbs playing a good game on defense. Second and 11 from the Union 21-yard line. Tyler, he's got such speed. He runs right in to number 33. That's Patrick Hollum. After a gain of five, Hollum, a 6'1", 185-pound senior, plays the rover position along with Dustin Steele.
This great Trojan offense just keeps the pressure on you every play. After every play, it's just right there on you. A
big third down here for the defense. They have to be getting a little tired.
Been a while since the Union offense has been out there, haven't it?
Yes, it has.
That's something that Jenks had, certainly one of the keys for this game, Keith Fuente, that Union offense off the field. Presley going for six. He's there. No good. No good. He went through his arms and he fell on it. It'll be fourth down. Boy, Beasley, who made such a tremendous catch earlier. Diving catch, had this one go right through the wicket.
And no one is more disappointed than the young man right there, because he certainly in no way intended for that one to slip away.
Wingerter on for another field goal. Into the game to snap is Ryan Dunlap, 5'10", 220 junior. He'll snap it to Presley, who will hold it for John's third field goal attempt of the game.
I think you're going to see a lot of pressure come this time, because they certainly would like to keep that lead at six and not let it go to nine.
Steele went after it. Kick is long enough. Good. Put it on the board. The junior kicker adds his third field goal of the game. This one from 34 yards out. So he's kicked field goals of 37, 31, and 34. And he'll kick off to the Redskins, who are very much still in this game. 8:04 to go, first half. Jenks up 16-7. It took four plays, 4 yards, 2 minutes, after they recovered the fumble on the kickoff return. That has been the only turnover of the game.
Well, let's see where they kick the ball this time and see if they try to keep it away from Eric Bernard. I would, wouldn't you?
Oh, yes. Worked last time, didn't it?
Yes, it did. Got them 3 points.
Bernard is deep along with Daney. Uh-oh, they're going to mess it up again. This one goes into the end zone. They'll have to down it. They don't have it. Oh, it's an automatic touchback. They did cover it. There's that rule I like. Let it get in the end zone, and it's an automatic touchback. But they did touch it back on the field of play. That's even worse. If you muff it, you got to go back there and get it and make a decision.
Don, we're going to get you on the rules committee next year. But I have to agree with you, on especially on a play like that. But the impetus of the kick was what took it back into the end zone, and they'll put it in play on the 20. But I'm sure one thing that Eric Bernard is going to be telling Daney, get away from the football and let me have it.
Well, Fuente hadn't been on the field in a while. Neither is his offense. He'll go to work quickly. Or will he? Go! Wisney sacks him for a loss of four. Jerry Wisney, whose dad played on a national championship team at Notre Dame.
And Jerry Wisney shows you just exactly why he's such a highly recruited lineman for his size, Don. 6'7", 276. Great movement.
He moves well there into the encroachment zone. So the 4 or 5 yards that he got on the sack, he gives it back to him.
He wants that ball snapped. He's ready to go. That's what, when you get a sack, that's what happens.
Yeah, you're ready for that
second. That's right. Snap that ball. Let me back here again. That front four, defensive four for Jenks, does a tremendous job in there. They keep a lot of pressure. They're not back there sacking on every snap, but they're putting pressure on Fuente every time he handles the football.
That's something Ron Lancaster talked about before the game. You don't have to sack him every time, but you at least put some pressure on him. Bernard, we haven't seen the screen. He dropped one earlier. 30, 40, gets a block, 50. And that shows you right there why Union produces more yardage than any team in the state, 43 yards.
What a great block. We will see Levitin. I couldn't pick out who it was, but if you'll watch Wisney, he really gets upset right there, and that keeps him out of there, lets the screen develop, and once Eric Bernard gets it, he follows his blocker so well. Looks like he's going to get caught about midfield there, but he's able just to elude him. And gosh, he has some quickness, plays off another great block there.
Ivory with the downfield block. Puente goes to work. He'll go deep, trying to get the momentum back. Yes! Seven-yard strike from Fuente to Nathan Ritter, who will try and add the extra point and put the Trojans to within two. And he does. Midway second period.
What a great pass from Fuente right over the left shoulders there of Ritter. Just makes it look easy. That's what this Union offense can do, Don. They can strike so quickly, and I'm sure that's going to be a big factor in the second half, where Jenks can take the football, maintain possession of it, run time off the clock.
FM, rock and roll, news, jazz, sports. The Rogers State College Broadcasting Division can put you in the control room.
FM 91.3, your classic hits.
Live on-air experience and hands-on audio production taught by industry professionals.
Bonnie Raitt, The Beatles, Elton John, keep it right here.
Get experience, get contacts, get placement. The RSC Broadcasting Division is the right call. Rogers State College, lifetime learning close to home.
Okay, gang, who are we here for? Who keeps us in business?
Customer.
What's our number one priority?
Customer.
Who are we going to make smile today?
Customer.
Who are we going to make smile today? Come on!
Customer.
Here's the kickoff. It's short from Ritter, taken at the 21 by Kalmus. Near the 30, look at the red shirts swarming under at the 30-yard line. Number 10's in on the play. Backup quarterback, Jaron Como, 5'11", 165 junior.
And you can see and feel momentum swinging in this game. One team has it, suddenly it's grabbed by the other team, and I'm sure it's going to swing back and forth a number of times before this is over.
37-yard pass, touchdown from Fuente to Ritter. Makes it 16-14 Jenks, thanks to three Trojan field goals. Fumble. This one's wild. Redskins. No signal officially. The senior middle linebacker with the fumble recovery, and the Trojan fans are stunned now.
And Matt Wilson that time, Don, he was going to make absolutely sure everyone knew who had the football. He held on to it until they had everyone unstacked.
Boy, momentum has been something in this second period. Great field position for the Redskins. Bernard to give Union the lead to the 8-yard line. Saving the touchdown was number 80, free safety Terry McCowan. A 22-yard run for Bernard.
Dane Ivory really gives Eric Bernard a great block out in the right flat that you'll see coming up. It may not be in the screen, but he gave him a great block out there, right in there. Could have been a clip, but he played it very well. Let the defender turn and come into him.
First and goal. Could be at about the 7-yard line. Cottrell, the center, to Fuente. to Bernard, to the 5, to the 4, to the 3, to the 2, to the 1. Touchdown! And the Redskins, ranked number 4 in the state, have the lead for the first time with 6:08 remaining. It was just 4 minutes earlier in this game. In fact, it was much shorter than that, about 3 minutes ago on the clock when Jenks had a 16-7 lead.
What a tremendous effort in there by Eric Bernard and a great block in there, leading the way by big number 77, Kent Hughes. And again, Eric Bernard just follows his blocker so well. He had another couple of good blocks in there, but Hughes was kind of the big hole that he was following.
Well, the difference in this game right now, JV, is that they both exchange fumbles deep inside each other's territory. Union's defense holds Jenks to 3. Here, Union gets the 6 to take the lead.
And the explosiveness of the Redskin offense was demonstrated right here in the last 3 minutes. They can march the length of the field in just a snap of the finger, and then with a break, turn right back around, put 14 points on the board before you can even bat an eye.
Here they're going to go for 2. Interesting scenario. Quinte in the shotgun. Bernard has it. 2-point conversion is successful, and the Skins lead it 22-16.
Well, this is a great call in here by Bill Blankenship, one which you just have to look at the numbers. He certainly would rather be ahead 6 than 5, because with the great kicking ability of Jenks, they could come back and score on 2 field goals. At least then it would be a tie. So he went the sure way out, and execution was perfect on the 2-point conversion.
Well, the fans have gotten their money's worth. 38 points in the first half. There's your scoring drive after the fumble. Bernard, his first touchdown of the game, and his 12th of the season. He is now tied with Steve Bilby of Sepulpa, second in the league in touchdowns with 12. Richie Calmaso leads that department. He has 21 on the year, including one tonight for Jenks, and he awaits the kick, along with Tyler, who will field this one in the end zone.
Now, you know that the Union offense is telling the defensive kids as they come on the field, get the football back. Let us have it again. We're hot. We want it. And on the other hand over there, you know that from the Jenks side of the field, they want to get a good drive going here and put some points on the board themselves.
In a matter of 49 seconds, the Redskins have bolted for 2 touchdowns before a crowd that is standing room only here at Union Tuttle Stadium. And the Redskins lead at 22-16 as you take a look at the Trojan possessions. First 4 they scored, the last one they fumbled. Well done, Jim Trickett, and the rest of the crew. Almas bolts his way up for 10. Almas a year ago had 21 touchdowns, or 17 touchdowns, and already this is 21, 38 touchdowns in 2 years. Doesn't quite move the chains, giving 9 officially. Second, just inches. They'll give it to him again. He picks his way for 4. 5.
Very obvious that both teams are so excellent, well-coached ball clubs. The preparation that has gone into this game is very obvious because of the different things that they've done. And Don, you just have to pat both coaching staffs on the back and all of the players on the back, because they are putting on one whale of a show.
Ryan Presley came into this game inning 71% of his passes. He puts it up again. This one's a little short. I believe that's Ananias Carson, number 3 it is, the intended receiver. Presley on the night, a little bit below his 71% average, but still nice figures. 4 of 9 for 91 yards.
Always keep in mind that you might kind of relax here with Jenks and think they're going to do everything on the ground. About the time they do, Presley will throw one.
As he gets ready to do here. Lost football. It's a fumble. Jenks has it at the 23-yard line. Wow. It was Collins, I think, number 70, that just ate the junior quarterback up.
And what a break this could have been for Union had they been able to recover this, but it was.
That was 75, I beg your pardon. That's Rhett Grimes.
Really came in and forced the fumble. It looked for a moment as though Union was going to recover, but they never could find it.
Lost 10 on the play, but more importantly, kept possession of the football. After a loss of 10, third and long at their own 24-yard line. Presley sends everybody out but Kalmus. Incomplete. Looking for John Wingater, the kicker. And the Union fans are on their feet. Who says we don't have a defense?
And as the game progresses, Don, the crowd increases as the stands are full and they're now on both ends of the field.
Not one umbrella is up. That's good news. We certainly, even though we've had rain throughout the day, we've really been lucky with the weather. Here's the kick by Wingater, his first punt of the game, taken at the 50 by Steele. Ooh, a flag goes down, and that'll be blocking below the waist after the 28-yard punt. It looked as though the Union player who tried to form the corner there for Steele to turn after his 8-yard return will get called for blocking below the waist, which you can't do on kicks, and that's the case.
Looked like it was called on Jarek Duvall then. He got caught right there at the corner, and sometimes that's a very difficult situation. I think they eventually called it a clip, Don, because he actually came in from behind. But sometimes in those situations, that blocker can turn, or the defender there can turn just a little bit and turn a what looks like to be a fair block into a clip.
So after the major penalty, first and 10 at their own 42. Great field position for Justin Puente. Who's thrown two touchdown passes in this game. Has 13 on the season, 49 in his career. Hands off Bernard. Look at him go. To the 13-yard line, maybe further. No, they'll mark him out at the 13. Wow, that's a run of plus 40. He is sensational.
There's one thing you can't coach against. It looked like Fuente stumbled. He sidesteps a tackler there, gets a great block on the corner, breaks another arm tackle, and once he turns upfield, Don, there's nothing you can do about speed. Absolutely great angle in that they have on him finally to push him out of bounds there, 41 and 13 together. Greg Bauer and
Fuente overthrows his receiver, Ivory, out of the end zone. I don't think I've ever seen anybody do as many things on the football field as productively as Bernard. Now, Dustin Steele, Dennis was his brother. Dustin can certainly do a lot of things for Union, no doubt about it. But Bernard, as far as his speed and a threat of catching the ball out of the backfield, running, kickoff returns, he's also had a key interception this year on defense when they brought him in a few times.
And is he not really potent on that screen pass?
Draw play to the 10. Flag down. Bernard down in the end zone. But I think it'll be brought back. It will probably be brought back. Neil Lancaster, our referee, says yes. So both teams now have had penalties wipe out touchdowns.
And you look at the breaks, and they have fallen just about even thus far, Don. And there you get a great look at how quick Eric Bernard can cut and then hit hard at the goal line, but still has the power and the momentum to push himself in.
A
penalties have not been much of a factor, but they have come at crucial times for both teams in this game. Quinte, screen pass. Nice block. Touchdown! JB is shaking his head, and I know why. We've done a lot of games. I don't think we've ever seen anything like this, have we?
Really haven't, Don. And, you know, we just talked about the screen play and how potent he was. And we saw him last week against Broken Arrow when he would have a long gainer call back because of a penalty, and Bernard just turned right around and do it again.
Well, they're going for two again to give him a 14-point lead. What an explosion. And now they need to call a TO. 3:47 remaining. Let's take a look at their third touchdown in less than about 3 minutes.
Just kind of a little sidewinder type pass, but once Bernard gets it, you know, the speed again is just so incredible, and that's one thing you can't practice against. You can't practice against someone if you don't have someone who can run as fast and be as quick as he is, and not many are as quick as Eric Bernard.
He got a great block from starting guard Steve Wiedauer, number 50, the 6'2", 225-pound sophomore, and the only sophomore to start for Union. Had a tremendous block out front that cleared the way for Eric Bernard, the transfer out of Midwest City Albert, 5'10", 172-pound senior. Second team defensive back, as I mentioned, being recruited by a lot of schools, including Texas A&M.
Well, you know Eric Bernard's stock will go up after this game when you can do what he's done against the number one team in the state.
Three wideouts, two to the right. Bernard to the left, 2 points.
Misdirection play right there for Eric Bernard. Looks like he's going to his right, but as he takes the handoff, he cuts back against the grain and goes untouched for the two.
Most of the Jenks Union games, the previous 18, most of them have been defensive battles. Last year, though, Jenks won 31-24, and now it's Union up 30-16, and we haven't even reached halftime.
You watch Bill Blankenship work the near sideline, and he's just so calm and collected all of the time.
A lot of poise, isn't he? Never gets rattled. Certainly does have a lot of poise, a lot of composure.
Every coach has his own personality, but it certainly reflects on the team, and I think it's reflected on the bigness of this game with the Redskins, because when they were behind and looked like things were going against them, they still were just right in there.
Great kick. 8 yards deep. Well, the Trojans certainly have time after they built themselves a 16-7 lead. Union has responded with 23 points. We were mentioning that it wasn't raining, and now it's starting to rain again a little bit, it appears. It is raining, and they'll throw the umbrellas up. We'll see how that affects this game.
And Don, this is really a big series for the Jenks Trojans.
They need to play some smash-mouth football, power football that got them to the state championship a year ago. Kalmus, and that's a perfect play right there to the 27-28-yard line.
But the thing now is that Jenks can't take too much time in driving the football from one end of the field to the other. They've got to make some big plays in there. Kalmus quite capable of doing it, and I think Presley is quite capable of making the pass. Here you see Richie Kalmus again breaking through the right side, and he's just so tough to get down.
Gain of 9, make it second and 1 from the 29. Wide receiver each way. Presley looks left, goes this way. Yes, to the 45.
and Dykus apparently couldn't hang on to it. Incomplete. Or that's Owens, rather, the other tight end, who has a couple of grabs already in the game. That's all right. Stops the clock. Third and one coming up.
And that was a nice pass in there by the quarterback that time. Brian Presley, he laid it right in, but Owens just couldn't quite. It maybe it was a little low, and he gets hit as soon as he's trying to gather it in. And a great defense in there by the defensive backfield.
Third and one. Jenks 3 of 7 on third down conversions. Kalmus picks his first down. He needed to cross that yard marker and did so. He got 3.
And Steve Davis, 224 pounds, wrapping him up in there. One thing for sure, Don, the Jenks Trojans, they won't play as though they're 14 points behind.
Oh, you're right. Offensive line led by 73. You see the left offensive tackle, Ken Hill, 6'3", 308 pound senior. Play action, Presley rushed, gets it to his man Dykus, the tight end, and wisely out of bounds. Ivory on the defense. That's good for 9, 8 or 9 and a first down. Or close to it anyway.
Looks like it's about a yard short maybe of a first down.
Obviously on first down, if you get 8 or 9, it's very difficult to get a first down. So we'll give him 8 to the 40. 39.
Oh, here was a good pass under great pressure and a great catch in there by Dykus.
Dykus made some big catches in the state championship come from behind win over Edmond a year ago. And so did this quarterback, Presley. He has great poise as well. Kalmus across the 40. It was Kalmus who was hurt a year ago. Chris Jones was their leading rusher. That's a first. That is a first down. It was Chris Jones who was their leading ball carrier a year ago. He got hurt with an elbow injury. They brought Kalmus in, obviously, not far off between those two guys who combined for almost 40 touchdowns between them a year ago. Kalmus got hurt, though, in the first series of the state championship game. So they bring in a kid, Chris Tyler, 5'9", 168, junior at the time. Hadn't heard much about him. He'd returned a kick for a touchdown the week before in the state semifinal game. Lancaster said, I don't know if Tyler can carry 20 times. He carried almost 30 times, over 100 yards, 130 yards in the game-winning touchdown. So they certainly have some depth at running back. Tyler's been used mostly as a wideout, as a timeout is called with 2:18 to go in the first half.
It's the last time out for Jenks, as you see head coach Ron Lancaster visiting with his quarterback Brian Presley, and they're trying to get a little strategy going here in the last 2 minutes and 18 seconds, because they certainly, Don, would like to go in the locker room not trailing by 2 touchdowns, but by adding some more points to the board. And one of the most difficult things that both coaches are going to have to face from this point on is the fact that when you're leading by 2 touchdowns from the Union standpoint, don't get complacent. Remember that you're 2 touchdowns ahead. They can get those back just about as quickly. And at the same time, you want to keep your kids fired up from Jenks and the fact that 2 touchdowns is not that difficult to overcome.
Well, we expected an offensive show, and we've gotten that. But the thing that has really been the key in this first half has been the Union defense. 3 times, Jenks had to kick field goals. All 3 were successful. There's your timeout graphic. Jenks is out of timeout, so 2:18 remaining. First down pass for Brian Presley, incomplete. Looking for Tyler. We mentioned that Wisney, the great defensive tackle and offensive tackle for Jenks, being recruited by a lot of schools, including Stanford. So is Justin Fuente. He also being recruited by Stanford. Wouldn't it be something if those two end up at the same school no matter where they go? And that's certainly not unusual between these two schools, programs to produce players that play together in college. Presley on 2nd down. Screen pass, Tyler. Shakes off the block. Look out, Chris Tyler. He's got great speed and he stepped out of bounds. At about the 20, we'll see where they mark it. They're going to mark it back up at the 32-yard line.
And Chris Tyler has just about as much quickness and speed as Eric Bednarik, because once he turned the corner on the far side, Don, it looked like he was going to go. He was really tight roping it down. Great pass and a missed tackle right here. Just couldn't quite wrap him up in there. It looked like it was Shane Mooney.
Saving the touchdown was 22, Eric Bednarik. Superman. Take the 22 off his chest and put an S on it. First down from the Union 33. Plenty of time left for Tyler. Ooh, he gets introduced to the red shirt. 56, Matt Wilson, who had that big fumble recovery earlier.
Timeout's going to be a factor here for Jenks as they close out the first half, Don. With a minute 46 remaining, the clock running, they are out of timeout, so they've got to take the ball out of bounds in completion in order to stop the clock.
Presley on the season, 5 touchdown passes. Wilson in the middle, waiting for some action. Presley outside, needs to get out of bounds, and Carson does so wisely. Ivory made sure he didn't go any further, and a flag down, and that might go against Union. Corey Flager, number 36, is over there as well. Ball's at the 22-yard line. Pass of 8 and a first down. Nice job, by the way, the receiver, of getting to the first down marker as well as getting out of bounds as we take a look.
Just a real quick out. Carson not only was able to get out of bounds and stop the clock, but he also knew where that first down marker was to get the first down. Then the ensuing penalty, and Jenks is in business on the 11-yard line, 10 and a half.
12th first down on the pass play, 13th first down of the game on the penalty. First and 10 from the Union 11, minute 23 to go. Jenks has been down here before, but they've been shut down and have had to kick three-pointers. Tyler, to use his speed to the 6-yard line. Pulled down by 36, Flager, who was guilty of the penalty a moment ago. Gain of 5.
And that clock's running with a minute and 3 seconds to go, Don. So with no timeouts, they just have about 2 more plays.
Brain trust of Jenks. I formation. Clock at 50 seconds. Tyler, nothing doing. Might have fumbled the ball. 40 seconds and the clock's running. Loss of 4, back to the 10. They need to hurry. It's 3rd and 9.
That
28
ball,
seconds.
That ball, as you can see, was loose on the turf there, and Tyler comes right back in and gets it.
3rd and 9. They need a big play here. Play action, Presley. Yes, touchdown. Touchdown, Trojans. I think it was one of the tight ends, might have been Benny Owen, who made the catch. It looked like it was going to be intercepted for a moment. And then the other receiver, I'm not even sure if it was intended for him. We'll find out. But I think it was Benny Owen who caught it. And the Trojans try to add on their 23rd point of the game from Frank Winkhitter. This would make it a 7-point game.
What a cool, calm, and collected quarterback in Brian Presley. With the clock running out, has a little fake inside in there and then rolls out to his right, just waits for someone to open up, and finally he spots a receiver right there in the end zone, drills it right in on his belt buckle. That was thrown in there to Ben Owens, the tight end.
80-yard drive, 13 seconds left on the clock. They had 3:47 when they got it.
Now keep in mind, with 13 seconds to go, Union has 1 timeout remaining, and if that ball is kicked to Eric Bednarik, and with the capability he has of bringing it back, there is a possibility that Union could get back in, maybe within field goal range.
How dare you say that? I don't know if I can stand it anymore.
We will, by the way, we will watch the Union halftime performance. One of the best bands in the land, the Union Redskin Regiment, Renegade Regiment.
Award-winning band, Union High School. They've won honors all over the United States, Don.
It'll be a pleasure to watch them here at halftime of what has been as good a game as billed, and that's really unusual. When you've seen this much publicity and hype on a game that's been anticipated so feverishly by the entire city. It rained all day, but you couldn't wedge another person in the stadium that holds 10,000. There's probably 12,000 here, and it's certainly been a ball game in which the first series by Union, they had to punt. Jenks got the ball and scored in three plays. Big pass play to Kalmus for 53 yards. He scored from 3 yards out. It was 7-0. Union came right back, went 80 yards on their own with Fuente there, throwing his first touchdown pass of the night to make it 7-7, midway first period. Then Jenks came right back. They drove down for a 37-yard field goal to make it 10-7 after one period. They made it 13-7 early in the second period after they had a touchdown called back. They then recovered a fumble, so we got a flag down here at the end of the first half.
And, of course, the half cannot end on a penalty, so we'll find one more play here if they chose to do so.
So it was 10-7. It was 13-7 early in the second period, Jenks. We'll take a look at this play and the personal foul against Jenks with no time left on the clock.
Just a late hit on Eric Bernard. He gets through, and again, with time expired, he just won't give up. He just continues to try to get one more yard, and here you see it come in. A late hit, good call by the official.
So it was 13-7, Jenks, when Union fumbled the ensuing kickoff, and Jenks turned it into three more points to make it 16-7, three straight field goals by Union. Here's a pass play to Bernard. Again, no time left on the clock. They belt him. They make him pay the price. They say he was down at the 33, and that'll take care of the first half. So it was 16-7 with 8 minutes left in the first half, and that's when Union went to work. They got a 37-yard touchdown pass, came right back after a fumble on a 7-yard touchdown run to take the lead for the first time of the night, 22-16. They increased it to 30-16, but Jenks has come back at the end of this first half to make it a game again. It's Union 30, Jenks 23 after one half. We're coming back for halftime activities in a moment.
FM, rock and roll, news, jazz, sports. The Rogers State College Broadcasting Division can put you in the control room.
FM 91.3, your classic hits.
Live on-air experience and hands-on audio production taught by industry professionals.
Bonnie Raitt, The Beatles, Elton John, keep it right here.
Get experience, get contacts, get placement. The RSC Broadcasting Division is the right call. Rogers State College, lifetime learning close to home.
Okay, gang, who are we here for?
Customer.
Who keeps us in business?
Customer.
What's our number one priority?
Customer.
Who are we going to make smile today?
Customer.
Who are we going to make smile today? Come on!
Customer.
The Redskins, who were down by 9, come back to lead by as many as 14, now lead by 7, 30-23. All that just the first half. incredible between two teams that are the high-powered offenses that were billed accordingly. As we take a look at the Union High Steppers, and coming onto the field now is the Union Band. Put on a great performance at Broken Arrow last week. Certainly expect the same this week. We hope you're enjoying the prep football game of the week on TCI Cablevision of Tulsa.
Thank you.
It has certainly been a pleasure in weeks past to talk about the great preparation that high school athletic programs endeavor, but I don't think there's a band program or a activity that is certainly more astute when it comes to preparation than the Renegade Regiment, the Union Band, defending state champion high steppers under the 200 membership band under their leadership of L. Dale Barnett. Let's take a listen. crowd's loving it. Unfortunately, we are not able to give you the shot because our cameras are inside here underneath the roof from the rain. But let's take a look at the halftime statistics. What a great performance, first of all, by the band, who had Batman, the Joker. The only thing missing, Catwoman was there. The only thing missing was the Penguin. But, no, wait, here's JV.
Okay, Doc, get ready for an exciting second half of football.
Oh, my, there's a look at the fireworks. We see those halftime stats again in a moment. We'll show you that it has been an offensive explosion indeed. Jenks, unusually, 143 yards passing. They come into the game, the league's leading rushing team at 248 a game, well below their average. Look at the balance of Union.
But look at the time of possessions, only 7:27 for Union as opposed to 16:33 for Jenks, which shows you just how explosive this Redskin offense really is.
And again, it was 16-7 Jenks when Union scored three touchdowns in a matter of 3 minutes and 10 seconds. Here we go. Look out. It's another turnover. Caught at the 24-yard line. Tyler covered it up. Man, oh, man.
We have seen almost every play, I'm sure, in both playbooks tonight, Don, and that was just a chip shot in there that was going to be very, very difficult to do. Brian Presley throwing 8 out of 16, 143 yards, one touchdown. He can throw it as well as run the ball club on the ground.
Quinte, who hit 5 of his last 7 passes. Usual night for him, and Bernard with over 200 yards, 260 all-purpose yards. Here is Richie Kalmus. He gets 1, and that's about it. Well, they say 3. I beg your pardon. Just across the 25 to about the 26.
You'd like to think with a normal football game, Don, that whoever comes out here and really establishes themselves in the third period will win the football game, but not in this contest because the momentum has shifted so quickly at different times in the first half, hard to predict.
But wasn't that a big touchdown by Jenks at the end of the first half?
Yes, it was.
Presley to Carson by Ivory, but not by the other guys. Number 36, Corey Flager, the senior, comes in and makes the big tackle. Up to the 30, gain of 4, maybe just shy of the 30. It'll be 3rd and about 3 or 4.
Even though Ivory wasn't able to completely wrap him up, as you'll see right there, he did slow him down to where the excellent pursuit that Union gets was able to stop him.
30-23 at halftime. Trojans trying to drive for the game-tying touchdown. 3rd and 3. Kalmus has it as he crosses the 35-yard line. He ran right over number 47, Chad Daintus, also a track star here at Union, 3-year player for the Redskins.
Some great blocking up on the right-hand side of the line for the Jenks Trojans, and when you look at the way Richie Kalmus carries a football, he just kind of seeks you out in the backfield and tries to run over you.
13th first down of the game for Jenks, 16th first down. Kalmus comes from a great athletic family. Had a brother that played tight end here, who's now pitching for ORU, and has a younger brother, Rocky, that's in the 9th grade. He's going to be a good player.
Richard's father, Merle Kalmus, a long time coach in the Tulsa Public Schools, coached at Tulsa Central for many, many years. Outstanding baseball player. His uncle Richard played with the Los Angeles Dodgers.
2nd and long 3 from the 42. Presley out in the flat. No gain. Number 9, Jeremy Pike on the defense of number 3, Ananias Carson. I say no gain, I beg your pardon. That was not the line of scrimmage marker, but the first down marker.
Very close, but Neil Pennington taking a close look at it and giving the Trojans a first down.
Carson's been a busy guy on the football field tonight.
Thomas, great block to midfield, to the 45-yard line. That's a first down, or close to it. Take a look at this offensive line, blow them off.
I mean, they came off the line of scrimmage, a great comeback block in there by number 73, Ken Hill, springing him loose and just doing a remarkable job up in front, the offensive linemen are.
Gain of 9 seconds short. The Trojans doing exactly what they needed to do.
And they can do this, Don, as long as they're within one touchdown. But they fall behind two touchdowns as they were right before half. It really kind of takes them out of the game. Even though Presley can throw the ball, they still like to churn it up on the ground.
They certainly had a big 25-yard pass play. You remember in that drive at the end of the first half when they got to within a touchdown to Chris Tyler, 25-yard play down the sideline. Presley on second and short. Airs it out. Dane Ivory, the only two-way starter for the Redskins, makes the play.
Good defensive coverage there by the Redskins defensive secondary. Nice fake in there to Calmus. He really will neutralize the line of scrimmage, giving Presley enough time to throw. Now he's got enough arm strength on him, but just great recovery by Dane Ivory, and he's got the speed to do it.
Calmus gets the first down, needed to get inside the 44, and does that by about a yard or so. Third first down in this drive. You know, there are players who were saying, you know, our quarterback, Ryan Presley, you let him throw the ball like Justin Fuente does every game. He can air it out. He can throw it as well as anybody. He just doesn't get the opportunities that Fuente does. But who knows? Next year, Presley will be a senior.
There very possibly could do it. But, you know, always you have to keep in mind the great receivers that Fuente throws to makes it a lot easier for him than if he were throwing to kids who couldn't catch a football.
So power left, they go that way. Number 52, Steve Davis, who's played a big ball game for the Redskins up front, makes the stop after a gain of a pair for Calmus.
Steve Davis, not very tall, 5'7", but those 224 pounds makes it very, very difficult to move up front. Derrick Collins also doing an excellent job along with Rhett Grimes up front on the defensive four.
Coming into the game for Matt Wilson, who comes out, is Mike Crisp, number 61, backup center, backup middle linebacker. He's a junior. Mike's 5'8", 180 pounds.
John Bradbury, we didn't mention him, but those four kids have done an excellent job defensively for Union all night long. Don't get enough credit, those guys don't.
From the Union 41, Chris Tyler almost blocked it. Got a nice block and gets inside the 35, scoots down to the 33, close to the first down marker. Again, Tyler has been out most of the year with a broken thumb. Just had the screws removed from that thumb. He broke the joint there below the thumb. You see he has it taped up, has a small cast on it. It's a first down. Oh, what a pop that was. Steve Hobbs, 46, 5'11", 205-pound senior. We have a flag down in the backfield. Hobbs was a tight end, mostly used as a tight end last year. We have motion here on the Trojans. And as a defensive tackle, this year they moved him out to linebacker. Certainly paid off. Well, you look at the linebackers these two teams have had in the past. Union with Chad Magruder, Ryan Camburn, who's over at OSU. You look at Jenks, Brandy Crow, who got a scholarship to TCU. Last year they had a couple of dandy linebackers. Lance West and Paul Phipps. And this year, not much different. And the same for Union. First and 15 from the Redskin 38. 7.5 minutes to go. This is the opening drive of the third period. Yeah. Patrick Hollum, number 33, who had a 20-yard touchdown return of a fumble recovery against Ponca City a few weeks ago, comes up with the stop. Now before Kalmus drives from the 38 down just inside the 35.
It's one of the few times tonight that Kalmus has just been dropped as soon as contact was made on him, and he didn't bounce off and make another 3 or 4 yards. Good tackle in there.
Myron Noodleman wanting some defense.
He's got his fence with him, doesn't he?
Does a good job. Certainly entertains throughout the Tulsa area.
Kids love him, don't they?
Yes, they do.
Well, adults do as well.
After the gain of 3, 2nd and 12 from the Union 35. Presley, quick drop. Tyler shakes loose and gets close to the first down. My oh my. Jeremy Pike, the junior secondary player, had him wrapped up and Tyler twisted away.
This is effort like you can only see in high school football, Don. These kids are playing with all of their heart. And you would think right there immediately that Pike would drop him, but he just won't be denied, Chris Tyler.
About a foot short of the first down. The Union 24-yard line. There you see on the up the top of the screen how short they are. They get the first down and more. And Kalmus just dives inside the 20 to the 19. They have taken 6 minutes off the third period clock. We're midway in the third. Trojans driving for the game-tying touchdown. It's been tied once before at 7. Trojans' biggest lead after 3 field goals was 16-7. And then Union came right back to make it 30-16. Jenks added a touchdown at the end of the first half to close to within 7. They're on the move again. That's about 7. Hollum 33, Daney 47 combined to make the stop.
And this is the vintage Jenks football that you normally think of, Don. Taking the ball as they did on the opening kickoff of the second half and have run off half of the quarter. Run off almost 7 minutes of the clock here in the third quarter. And if they go in and score on this and tie the ball game, or they may elect to go for two and go ahead, well, then the momentum and the clock kind of gets in their favor unless Union can strike back very quickly.
First down and 10 from the Union 12. Pull back in motion. Kalmus the other way. It's wrestled down inside the 10-yard line to the 9. That'll be about 4. Tell you what, one guy I know is enjoying this game that has certainly been with us from the start when we started 7 years ago, our photographer Rick Scott. I know he's home watching this, and we certainly appreciate all the people that came out and helped us with Rick Walk 94 last week.
We really do want to express all of the different sports personalities and media celebrities that came out. They came out in large numbers, and it was very gratifying, Don, that we had a successful walk for our good friend Rick Scott.
First and goal just inside the 9. Hobbs, or rather Matt Wilson, who checked out of the game, checks back in, and Kalmus gets wrestled down. Close to the 6, it'll be 3 more, make it 2nd and goal.
And what an incredible time-consuming drive has been.
Only 3 passes. He's 3 of 4. Remember, the pass that was incomplete was knocked away that saved the touchdown by Ivory. Otherwise, Presley's been perfect in this drive. A couple of quick outs. In fact, all 3 passes were pretty much the same. 2 quick outs and then the button hook to Tyler, in which he twisted away needing 12 and got very close to the first down. The Union fans are yelping because an official called a timeout. Neil Pennington called an official timeout. And I think it was because one of the Jenks players might have had an equipment problem. And now Ron Lancaster, I think he's called for a timeout.
Well, you know, this drive orchestrated here by Jenks is something that had to be discussed in the locker room at halftime, that the Jenks would like to take the ball and drive it, and then play good hard-nosed defense and get the ball back in the fourth period. And with the kicker they have, Don, if they get within 30 yards, actually be 40 yards on the kick, why they feel like that they could win it. But they want to keep the ball away from Justin Fuente and the Union offense.
Well, here we go. To save a timeout, they've had to pull the quarterback, Presley, out of the game to save a timeout. So they bring in the backup, Greg Bauer, who starts at left corner on defense. 6'1", 170 junior, missed a year ago with a knee injury. He's certainly capable. Second goal from the six, or from the five, just outside the five. Helmus blasted at the line of scrimmage. No gain. It'll be third and goal. And take a look at this defensive hit by the Redskin defender.
Just a nice handoff in there to Rich Kalmus, one that he's been making yardage on, but that was just a great hit in there. Looked like Matt Wilson. He's been in there all night long.
Third and goal from the six. Will they let Bauer put it up? Checks off the play. 2:57 remaining. Jenks has had the ball the entire third quarter, and Kalmus has another one. That was an awesome run of 6 yards. Second touchdown of the night for Richie Kalmus, who leads the state in touchdowns with 22. Winger to tie the game. Yes. The Union fans are on their feet. The Jenks fans are on their feet. They've gotten their money's worth. I don't think I've ever seen a game, Coach, that was so highly publicized, so much anticipated. We mentioned it earlier, maybe the most anticipated prep football game in this town in 25 years, and it's lived up to the billing. We're tied at 30.
And what a great run for the touchdown in there by Rich Kalmus. Don, you're absolutely right. And so many times that a game like this can be hyped for as long as it has been, and then suddenly it just never materializes. But not the case here tonight. This has been just what everyone expected, and here they have 2:52 remaining in the third period. The score is tied. Nothing has been settled.
A 77-yard drive, and look at the plays. 18 plays.
And nine minutes and 8 seconds.
Well, here comes Superman. Bernard. Oh, that time he gets hit. Fumbles the football, I thought. No, he hung on to it. I beg your pardon. 23 yards on the return. He took a wallop from the guy that's slow in getting up, and that's 27, Scott Benicek, who's deadly on those special teams.
And it looked like maybe Benicek was injured there. His teammates picking him up, just carrying him off. Here we get a good look at Eric Bernard. See, he slows down just a little bit. Suddenly he hits that accelerator, and here he goes. But a great tackle in there by Scott Benicek that stopped him.
23-yard return by Bernard. He's now got 280 all-purpose yards in the game. Beg your pardon, he's 294 now. First carry the second half, and a flag is down as Bernard goes down in the backfield. I think it was Peaster 99, might have been Wisney 71.
It was, Don, it was Jerry Wisney. He comes in from the left side, and I mean, he came through there with no one stopping him.
A loss of one. Let's see if we can see it.
Here we'll see a picture of him. Here he comes right there, just no way. I mean, the big man can really move.
Face mask, and they'll give him a major. First down, Union. They're 13th of the game. By the way, in that 18-play, 77-yard drive, 5 first downs for Jenks. First down, 42-yard line. Long check by Fuente. Look at the receivers at the top. Trips to the right. Tied in. No tied in. Dustin Steele tries to give some room to Bernard to turn the corner, and he turns nothing but speed for three or four.
And that's just a great individual effort right there, because he didn't have the blockers out there. He just outran them. around his right end, was able to pick up a couple of yards. Most players down would have lost three or four.
Bill Blankenship there. Second seven from the 45. I hope he ate at the same place he's been eating at every Friday. We'll talk about that after this second down play from the 45-yard line. Pressure. Look at him. He always dumps it off on that. When there's pressure back there, he knows exactly where to go to Bernard. That's why he very rarely gets sacked.
That was an interesting story that Benny Dixon told me before the game, that he and Bill Blankenship, Benny, the athletic director here at Union High School, he and Bill Blankenship go to the same restaurant every Friday and eat. They drive Benny's truck, and the first time they went up and the streak started, they almost ran out of gas. So now each Friday when they go to lunch, why, they drive the pickup and they try to have it just barely enough gas to get to the restaurant and get back. And Benny said that last night he had to drive his truck about an hour and a half to burn some gas out of it so that they could have a similar situation. Then they get to the restaurant today at Friday at noon, and so what? Someone has their favorite booth, so they have to go to the manager, and he moves the people out and lets them come in there. I asked him, I said, are you superstitious? He said, of course not.
Third and seven, shotgun. They put some pressure on Fuente. He unloads it. Bernard couldn't hang on. At midfield, it would have been short of the first down. But there is an incredible pass play by Fuente right there.
That really is, and he had the ball right in there on the mark, but just couldn't quite be held on to by.
Look at him just float it out here. It's a wet football.
It right over there, but Eric Bernard just couldn't quite gather the ball in. Now, this is exactly what I think the Jenks had planned at halftime to do. Was to score, hold them, get the football back, and they may keep it for 9 minutes again.
Well, they're not defending state champions for nothing. Down 30-16, they've tied it at 30 now. And Steele, who had a lousy punt last time, not so good this time. Man, oh man. Dustin Steele is struggling in the punting game. He came in averaging 33 yards a kick. That one's good for 14. His previous kick was 5. And again, he gives the Trojans great field position up at their own 41-yard line.
And those are the phases of the game of football that coaches talk about so often that can be the difference in winning and losing in that kicking game. And it certainly has given Jenks great field position.
First and 10. Union shows blitz at the 41-yard line. Burkhart, the fullback in motion. Kalmus to the outside. Hollum chases him. Gets some help from Daney. And a yard, and that's it. I beg your pardon, he gets 4 yards. I don't know what in the world I'm looking at tonight. 4 yards, second and 6.
You know, Richie Kalmus, when he's running east and west, he's got quite a bit of speed as well. See him give a little stiff arm there, but finally he is pushed out of bounds by Chad Daney.
Second 9 from the 45, a minute 20 remaining. Burkhart on the wing, play action. They set up the screen. Dykus couldn't hang on to it.
Now once again, the Union defense called upon on a big third down play in order to get the football back before the end of the third quarter.
Well, this Union defense has been maligned a bit this year, but even though they've got 30 points against them in this game, they've made some big plays. After the poor punt, draw play. Loss of 5 on the play, back to the 40.
Who's in that backfield again? Matt Wilson. I think you can credit the Union fans because they were just standing in unison cheering right there as Matt Wilson blitz takes care of Richie Kalmus on that play.
This is only the second punt of the night for John Winkender. He's the conference's leading punter at 41 yards per kick. And we'll have a penalty here. Somebody jumped in the neutral zone. Dustin Steele awaits the punt with 33 seconds remaining in the third period.
that's really going to give Union Redskins an opportunity to come out here into the fourth period with good field position.
The wind is to the back of the kicker. So when Union starts the fourth quarter, they'll have the wind. High kick, pressure is on. Steele lets it hit at the 40, picks it up at the 26. And that's about as far as he can get. Nine-yard punt. Dustin Steele gets credit for three on the return. And we'll have one more play in the third period.
And that win could be a very important factor in the fourth quarter.
Line of scrimmage, the 29. At least 10,000 in attendance, and they have gotten their money's worth. As the third period comes to a close, it belonged to Jenks. When the Trojans got the opening kickoff, almost lost it on a fumble on the kickoff return. They went back, recovered it at the 23, drove 77 yards in 18 plays, and tied the game as we head to the final 12 minutes of regulation. It's top-ranked and defending state champion Jenks tied with the fourth-ranked Union Redskins as we continue our prep game of the week. Glad you're watching it with us on TCI Cablevision of Tulsa.
Rice, only a good energy food for the active athlete. No, it's also the best initial treatment for sprained joints. Are we advocating putting rice on a sprained ankle? Not exactly. You see, rice is a memory word for rest, ice, compression, and elevation, the best beginning treatment for injured joints. Apply compression carefully. Remember, a wrinkled or too tight ACE wrap can act like a tourniquet. Then elevate and rest the extremity and pack it in ice. When in doubt, with any extremity injury, remember, ice is nice.
Oh, I've always dreamed of a big family room.
Wow!
Call today, Communication Credit Union at 258-7646, the credit union for all of Broken Arrow.
I've always dreamed of a convertible sports car.
Call today, Communication Credit Union at 258-7646, the credit union for all of Broken Arrow.
Start the fourth period, tie game. Two top offenses in the state getting their money's worth to the 10,000 in attendance. This third down pass way overthrown. And it'll bring up a fourth down, and the Trojan defense is held. And here comes Dustin Steele. Well, he was scheduled to punt instead. Well, we'll see. I don't want to be premature. Yes, they are bringing him out. Look at the time of possession, JB, in the third period. Jenks already had it quite a bit in the first half of over 9 minutes.
And again, Don, I'm sure that's exactly what the Jenks coaching staff wanted to do, was maintain possession, and they certainly did, limiting Union to less than 2 minutes.
30 minutes time of possession for Jenks in the game compared to 8 minutes for Union. Steele's had a tough night. This time he gets away a boomer. Nice kick at the 40, inside the 30, inside the 20. That was a nice kick. Just a matter of time before that kid came through for you. 52-yard punt for Dustin Steele, the league's leading receiver. Career 75 catches at Union.
And certainly a very important punt, Don. They needed to get it off and keep Jenks out of good field position. And keep in mind that wind's coming out of the north at a pretty strong gale. And if they can hold, when I say they, if the Union Redskins defense can hold, force Jenks into a punting situation, the wind could be a factor. But you know what Jenks is going to do. They're going to keep that ball on the ground and try to consume that clock.
Second possession of the second half. Tyler for about five.
The wind has not bothered Wingeter at all on the field goals that he has had earlier in the ball game, Don, but I think it's going to come right down to the toe of someone here in the end. I'll tell you what, he has had a great night. Chris Tyler has.
Starting on defense tonight, but he's getting a lot of work. Second and six from the 23-yard line. Presley is back in at quarterback. Tyler slips down, trying to get the lead block from the tight end, Owens. Ball's down at the 28, a gain of five. He'll be just short of the first down marker. Be a long yard, maybe a yard and a half. Needed to move the chains for the Trojans. Tied with the Redskins, 30-30.
Tyler taking a little pressure off of Richie Kalmus.
Presley, who was knocked out of the game. Bauer came in for a couple of plays on that last touchdown drive. Richie Kalmus, give him eight. It's a first down. And the Trojans are on the move again. Kalmus has had a big night. Two touchdowns on the evening, 22 on the season. He came into the game as the conference's leading rusher. Beg your pardon, he was 30 yards behind Bernard. He came in as the second leading rusher in the conference. He has not disappointed tonight. Ball at the 35-yard line.
It's like you had the long count going that time, and every penalty in the fourth quarter can be crucial because it sets up a situation where they can get another first down, keep that clock running, and get that ball someplace within distance for John Wingeter to put it through the uprights, Don, and I still think it's going to come down to that.
Brian Presley, the Jenks quarterback, certainly was excited to play in this game because he grew up in Midland, Texas, transferred and moved into Tulsa and started at Union in the sixth grade. He said, I grew up watching Midland Lee and Odessa Permian. Of course, the book was written about that, Friday Night Lights, and he's involved in one here this evening from Union Tuttle Stadium. Presley hands to Carson on the reverse, and he dives to the 42. Remember, it was a first and five situation, so not much harm done there. And we have a flag down at the tackle. Personal foul against the Skins. Both teams have been hit with personal foul penalties. Couple on the Redskins.
A little reverse that time, and you can see there's still a lot of water down on the turf.
This will move them inside the 50, down to the Union 44-yard line. 8:54 remaining. Well, teams at the 70-yard mark in penalties.
That's just good hard football. When they play as hard as they play tonight, Don, they're going to get the penalties. A very well-called ball game by Mr. Pennington and his crew.
Greg Bauer in at quarterback. Number 13. Quick pass, yes. First down to the 34-yard line. Wingeter, the kicker, makes the catch. Penalty down, though. They'll go against the Trojans after a gain of 10.
Both teams could be getting a little tired right now. Don, I think you can rest assured that this will not be the only game these two teams play against each other this year. I'm sure we're going to see them in the playoffs down the road, probably like in maybe the second round of the state.
Maybe the state final in Stillwater. Not out of the question. 8:32 to go in the game. We're tied at 30. Jenks with the wind in their face at about 20 miles per hour on a cool, damp night, but nobody's complaining. The spirits certainly haven't been dampened by the weather.
Second down and 25. They lost it down on the play. On the personal foul. Up to the 45 or thereabouts is Richie Kalmus.
John Bradbury get it coming out of his defensive line position, really stacking up the entire right side.
Kalmus, who averages almost 8 yards per carry. Again, over 2,200 yards rushing in his career. 39 career touchdowns. Greg Bowers, the new quarterback. Great baseball player. Third and 21. Will he go upstairs from his own 45? Shovel pass. Kalmus, good call. Midfield. Slips down just shy of the 45-yard line. They'll need another 11 to get the first down. It'll be fourth and 11 after the 10-yard play.
That was a well-executed play that time, and fooled me. I didn't think I thought he still had it, but he shuffled it just at the last moment, and Richie Kalmus is certainly utilizing his power.
Fourth and 11. They will drop back and punt. Wingeter is back for only his third punt of the night. He has only punted, JV, 9 times all season. Incredible. 7 times in 5 games. Now this being a 6th game, this is his 10th punt of the season.
When you have the number one offensive team in the state, I don't suppose that you have the opportunity very often, because they're scoring or knocking on the door about every possession.
Now, even though they didn't get a first down, they got some yardage to get out to midfield and pin Union deep. They kick it away from Steele. Not much of a Jenks bounce. It hits at the 20, and it'll be down there. They didn't get the roll they wanted after the 26-yard punt. 7:06 remaining in the game.
Now you can see the coaches talking to the players as they come off, talking to them as they come on, and it's down to the point of where one drive, just one great effort by either the defensive unit or the offensive unit, can give one of these teams a mighty important win.
Union has a couple of 80-yard drives to their credit in this game. Play action to William, the tight end who caught the first touchdown of the game. They're going to rip his jersey off to get him down. Close to the 35 and a flag down again after the play. Yard pass play to the Union tight end.
I really thought that Justin Fuente at that time was getting awfully close to the line of scrimmage before he threw it.
Unsportsmanlike conduct against the Trojans.
Tempers are just a little short. Here is a great fake in there to Eric Bernard, and as he rolls out to the right, he's really getting real close to it before he dumps it off to his tight end. Good enough for a first down, and I don't know where the unsportsmanlike conduct came. Just a good struggling tackle in there.
First time for Union in Jenks territory in the second half. 6:40 to go. Tied at 30. There's the penalty graphic. There's Eric Bernard. Nowhere to go is the right cornerback, Jake Raymer. 5'9", 150-pounder, comes up to make the big play on Bernard, who is close to the 300-yard mark and all-purpose yardage in the game. That's a loss. Back to the 46, a loss of a yard.
Justin Fuente gets the signal real quickly from Bill Blankenship, and he's right back up under. And there you can see Ron Lancaster. He's pacing the sideline.
Actually, a loss of about 3. They were up at their own 49, back to their own 46. Fuente in trouble. Second sack of the game.
He wasn't about to throw the football then, not being absolutely sure. It was good coverage by the secondary of the Jenks Trojans, and a smart play. You certainly, at this point, with 5:30 left in the game, you don't want to be throwing up any interceptions. Of course, he's only had 3 the entire season. Here you see him. He just can't find his receiver. He steps up, but no way he's going to get away from that. Jenks defense.
99 Peaster with the initial hit, and then defensive right tackle Dustin Parker finished him off. Third and 15. Union at their own 42-yard line. He has time here over the middle. Intercepted.
Terry McCowan, the free safety to midfield. Yard return by the free safety. 6'1", 165-pound junior.
And who makes the tackle at midfield? Number 22, Eric Bernard. You won't see this happen very often. Pass down the middle, just overthrow the intended receiver. And here comes McGowan back with it. There is Bernard coming in there, taking his feet right out from under him.
The Redskin defense being called upon again. Presley is in at quarterback. They started to shuttle the QBs a bit in this second half. Kalmus. It's five. We're approaching the 4-minute mark in the game. Union putting their three-game home winning streak on the line.
Are we looking at overtime, Don?
Could be. Wouldn't be a bit surprised. And with these two kickers, we'll be here for a while, huh?
Yes, we could.
Union's won 23 of the last 28 here on this stadium floor. Kalmus. Gets three. It'll be third and two.
And it looks like the defense is punishing Richie Kalmus, and it looks like Richie Kalmus is punishing the defense.
You are so correct.
Kids are playing hard. This is what it's all about.
They'll bring the fullback in on third and two. That's 41, Burkhart, 6'1", 175 senior. Junior quarterback, Presley. Kalmus, first down and more to the 35-yard line and then some as we hit the 3-minute mark. Tied at 30. After it was 30-23 at half, it's become a defensive standstill here in the second half after the Trojans got the opening kick in the second half and marked 77 yards and 18 plays.
And you know what's going through the mind of number 82, John Wingutter. That it's going to come down to his foot any moment.
After a gain of seven, down to the Redskin 34, first down. Kalmus again to the 30. Daney with another tackle. He's had several in this game. 2:40 remaining. They'll mark it at the 27 and a half. Look at the yardage for this kid, Richie Kalmus.
What a great rivalry has come about between Union Jenks, Union Broken Arrow, Broken Arrow Jenks.
Second and three, as you see. Kalmus gets two of it. Clock down to 2 minutes. Going to be very close. They give him a pretty good spot just inside the 25. Both teams have plenty of timeouts. They mark it now right on the 25. Third and a yard. Presley the quarterback, Burkhart the fullback. He'll lead for Kalmus. Needed one, got nine. First down, Jenks, the Trojans, 24th. First down of the game.
And what a tremendous job the right-hand side of the offensive line for the Trojans is doing in giving that running back, Richie Kalmus, just enough room to get across that line of scrimmage, and he's going to pick up some yards. Good blocking.
Time of possession has been so critical in this second half. It didn't hurt Union in the first half because they struck so early. Three touchdowns in over 3 minutes and 10 seconds. Kalmus, nothing this time. He gets ushered out. Number seven, Dupler, came up initially, and then 36, Flager, finished him off. They'll mark it back at about the 17, no gain or maybe a loss of a yard. And Kalmus comes out
little bit shaken on that play.
But they stopped the clock with a minute and nine to go. And again, you have to be looking at John Wingether. He has to be getting warm.
He's kicked three field goals in this game. Second and 10 from the Redskins 16. To Tyler, big hole to the 10, to the 5-yard line. First and goal, Jenks, with a minute to go.
What a great run in there by Chris Tyler and a great call by the quarterback and the offensive coaches for the Jenks Trojans. You see him cutting off a great block up front. They were really keying on Richie Kalmus on that last play.
Trojans call a timeout. 52 seconds remaining in the game. Both communities have come out in force. It has been a beautiful thing to behold, and 30-30 our score with 52 seconds left. We've seen about everything we thought we would, and then some.
And Don, for the last 2 weeks in a row, we've seen a full stadium for high school football, and that's really refreshing and encouraging for all of the metropolitan area high school football teams.
Trojans are trying to win their third straight from Union. They've won 12 of 18 meetings between these two schools, and the prep football game of the week, which we're so proud to bring you each week, is being sponsored by State Bank, Eastern Oklahoma Orthopedic Center, the Williams Companies, and RSC-TV, Rogers State College Television. First and goal from the Union Redskin 4-yard line. Tyler. To the 3. Second goal from the Redskin 3. 40 seconds left and the clock is ticking.
Well, they have time for about one more running play.
Union calls a timeout.
Who do you think will carry the football?
Either Tyler or Kalmus is ever in there. I'll tell you what, JB. Presley is over there getting a breather, getting some water. I was so impressed. We talk about Fuente's poise and his composure. But this kid came in as a sophomore last year for Jared Hart, who was injured. Presley, here's a sophomore, he's never started a game. Comes in the playoffs, guides him to a semifinal come-from-behind win over Midwest City at Lewis Field. And then, just like tonight, when the Trojans had to move down the field, had to control the football game, Presley did it with them in the state championship game, of all things, in the win over Edmond, and he's done it here tonight.
And he's got an excellent opportunity, either one of these teams, Don. I haven't seen Midwest City and some of the Western teams, but I think we very possibly could be looking at the next 6A state champion, whether it be Jenks repeating or whether it be Union knocking on the door. But these two teams are awfully good 6A football teams.
Well, again, the last 6 years, a touchdown or less has decided this rivalry. Going to be the same in 1994. 36 seconds remaining in a tie game. Kalmus. Touchdown.
Oh!
Richie Kalmus, his second touchdown of the second half. The last one to tie it, this one to put the Trojans back in front. Wingerder, who's had a busy night with three field goals. And his fourth PAT.
The question, can Justin Fuente take his ball club in 33 seconds to get a tying score? Don't count them out. Here we get a good look at the strength of Richie Kalmus. He was met head up in there about a yard from the goal line, but just sheer power and desire to get in for six gave Jenks a touchdown.
Trojans led 7-0 in the first period. Union came right back to tie it. Jenks came right back to kick a field goal to make it 10-7 after one period. Early in the second period, they made it 13-7. They then recovered a fumble, kicked another field goal to make it 16-7, and then Union electrified this big crowd with three touchdowns in a matter of 3 minutes and 10 seconds. To make it 30-16 Union. Jenks scored a touchdown at the very end of the first half to make it 30-23 at halftime, and the Trojans get a touchdown in the third to tie it. One here at the end of the game to take the lead. 37-30.
Justin Fuente was getting some last minute instructions from Bill Blankenship, and you know he's going to utilize his timeouts. I think he has two remaining. He's going to utilize those timeouts, try to get people out of bounds, kill the clock, and still have a chance to win.
63 yards away. They go to shovel pass to Bernard to the 43, and they'll have to spend one here as he didn't get the first down. Gain of 5. This is a Union offense that, remember, last week went to Broken Arrow, where the Tigers had given up just 560 total yards in their first four games. And the Redskins ravaged them for almost that many yards in one game.
There you see Bill Blankenship talking to his offensive players. He's trying to utilize everything he can in the final 18 seconds. I'm sure they've got to be down and out. Pattern, stop the clock, get the first down with the no huddle offense. He can come right back and put it in play. He can get three plays in, Don. And who knows, they may go for the bomb on the first snap.